I reviewed these the other day, didn't I? And this particular flavour I very much liked. It's the vanilla cold espresso monster. And I had loads of people... I had loads of people commenting saying, what will it taste like if I velvetise it? Purposely heating up an intentionally cold espresso. I'd have to give that a go. Why not? Turn it on. I'm hoping it still works, actually, because I have enough put all sorts in this, haven't I? That's lovely. We'll pour that in. And, oh, look! It goes right up to the max line. To the max! Excellent. So that means there's a triple shot in these. So when I reviewed two of these and I had six shots of coffee, I get to keep this one in the fridge for after the video. Lovely. I'm going to plop that in. There we go. Is it plopped in? It is now. And let's see it swell. Oh, it's swelling. Good, 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 good. I always wanted to know what or not cold espresso will taste like. We'll plop on the lid. I think plop is the word of the day, don't we think? Right, the dishwasher's finished, so I should have a cup to put it in. There we go. Fresh out the dishwasher, so it's still nice and hot. I'll empty that later. Oh, I love having a dishwasher. Come on, hurry up. I'm looking forward to it. Yeah, this is absolutely lovely. I liked this very much. Let's drags out the can. Lovely. We'll read where it says whilst we're waiting for it to velvetise. Europeans are famous for the fast cars, fashion and coffee served long, short, hot, cold, you name it. So we travelled the continent, learned from the best baristas and created our latest coffee espresso monster. Espresso monster is a triple threat, three shots of espresso, ice cold milk, monster's espresso energy blend. Because when it comes to coffee, we're a sophisticated beast. Did they really travel the continent? Did they really send people out? Did they really go to Italian, French coffee shops? Proper bespoke little... whatevers, you know, down the little nooks and crannies of all the streets and say, give us your secrets so we can put it in a can. There we are. That should sort out anyone thinking if this was some kind of paid for video. It is absolutely not. Got this myself. Yakety yakety yak. It's nearly done now. It only takes a couple of minutes to make a hot chocolate. And it'll turn itself off. It's still... And... Is it starting to wobble now? It starts to do this weird little wobble thing, then you know it's done. Or nearly done, rather. I think just turning off is not good enough, though. That's what always bugged me about this. It just turns off. It'd be nice if it had a nice little audible ting! Or a nice audible... You know, a nice subtle noise, such as... Oh, I don't know. Knife and fork draw. Yeah, you know, just to let you know it finished. What other nice noise could it make so you know it was done? What about a foghorn? There, it's done. Ooh, it has frothed up, hasn't it? Oh, that looks lovely. Oh, this is still warm. Ooh. Oh, I love that sound. Oh, it has frothed it up, look, because it doesn't fit in the glass this time. Is it going to overflow? Is it going to overflow? The answer will be no. Get the frothage out of there. Froth. Froth. I like the word. Froth. You've got to say it really croaky, like froth. Then really go along on the part of the word. There we go. And it smells blooming lovely. Oh, it's very nice. I think it might need a bit of sugar in it. Might put a bit of sugar in it. Sugar, not candor. No, I put some fake candorel in it. There we go. And put a few of them in it. And give it a stir. Like that. Bearing in mind this is meant to be an energy drink mixed with coffee, and I've just velvetized it, I've just put in some fake candorels. I'm surprised it's worked so well. Well, I don't even know yet. I've not even tasted it with the fake candorels yet. Oh, when it does work. I'm surprised. I've just realised, that's weird. I've had to add more sweetness to it. Maybe the heating's got rid of the sweetness of what little sweetness there was in this. Because it was more vanilla-y than sweet. This is gorgeous. Oh, that's absolutely gorgeous. Oh, if you see these in the shop and you think, do you know what? I really fancy like a cold coffee, but I don't want it cold. I want to eat it up. Eat it up. Heat it up. It's a revelation. Amazing. Oh, that is gorgeous. So if you've got a velvetizer or some kind of whisk, maybe you can whisk up some cold coffee and make it hot. Oh, that's lovely. Oh gosh, I'm really getting a bit of a buzz now. Because not only is it a triple shot of coffee in there and an energy drink, but now that it's hot as well. Oh, there we have got one of the letters in the word hot. 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 It's really going to me. It's really waking me up. Wow, that is really strong. I've not even had half of it. For some reason, heating it up's made it even better. Flipping heck, I feel like I could win the marathon right now. I don't know what happens by heating this up, but it absolutely works. And you've got to try it. And it tastes so good. Anyway, thanks for watching. Please scrass. Let me know in the comment section down below. Are you going to try these either hot or cold or both? Flippin' heck. This will wake you up on a Monday morning, when you've really got to drag your carcass out of bed and drag yourself onto the bus, tube, train, bike, whatever form of transportation, or indeed walk. Flipping it, this will wake you up. This is good stuff. Anyway, thanks for watching. Scrass, that means subscribe, comment, rate and share. And don't forget to bell me. See you when I see you. Bye.